How's it gonna go live? Here we go. Good morning. Welcome to Sunday morning coffee. Nice and shiny morning. Lots of people in there. So good morning. I've got lots of very good news. I'm in a very good mood. So naturally, I'm just going to start with a bit of sombre news, but it gets it out of the way. So I'm not thinking about it to put at the end. So there's lots of exciting things coming up, bad Squiddo and non-bad Squiddo related. So don't go anywhere. But to begin with, may I just mention that last Monday we did lose Karen Guinea Pig. She was nearly 7.5 years old and she did go peacefully into the night slash morning as I got her out for some nice cuddles and then I put her in with her friends for the most of it. And then I took her into my bed and gave her some little cuddles till she went. Which is very sad. I don't want to look like I'm not sad, but I've had my sadness this week. So I am then overshadowed by all the exciting things to talk about. But she got the death sentence. We were told about 4 months ago that she would be on her last legs, and she's done an extra 4 months, so that's really good. We knew it was coming, and she did just very suddenly go downhill. And it sucks. It's very rubbish. And I'd been having a very terrible month, so it was a good like extra thing on top. But thank you to Andy, who has added her to my guinea pig graveyard, of which I've been speculating that if aliens were to come and or people from the future and start excavating, they would definitely think there was some sort of guinea pig war fought in Nottingham, or they perhaps were the dominant species. Hello, Dave. Yes. So I now have two guinea pigs, which are Dave and Carol, who are unfortunately going to dwindle as I'm not. This is normally the point I would replenish the herd, but I'm not. I'm on my way out of theoretically having pigs. The big decision will be with the next pig, but that's for future me. Future me. But yeah, I've got these two. Listen to that. That's Carol, that is. So they were in mourning for a little bit, largely Dave, because Karen was his favourite and they were always grooming each other and cuddling and stuff. But I think he started to accept that Carol is there. No, they weren't. Karen was like the common interest or something. So they've been a bit quiet, but they're doing all right. But you put them, if you can, you put the body in and they have a little sniff so they don't think that an eagle, you know, there's suddenly a predator or something. That is, I'd say it was them wailing, but it's actually Dave pestering Karen in an inappropriate, Carol in a very inappropriate manner. But yeah, I just wanted to say thank you, everyone. That was awesome with Karen, because some of you had put some money towards, because she had some crazy vet bills last year, and some of you had done that and just sent really nice messages, and that's really cool. And she's been with us a very long time, and yeah, some pigs are quite special, so she was a special pig. So I wanted to get that before I go into my super excitement mode, because I don't, yeah, you know what it's like, it's a bit awkward, isn't it? So I'm gonna drink a tea. I'll have a salute of coffee to Karen, and then we'll move on to the exciting squid news. How about that? So yeah, Paul, a toast to Karen, the old gal. She had a horrible life before me, being back-to-back bred, and which can't be pleasant. But then she's had a nice retirement with all different friends over at mine. So that's got to be something, isn't it? So to Karen, we'll have a little scooch. We're having a toast to Karen, Dave, if you want to join in. He said he's going to join in. So that was quite a slurp, wasn't it? Slurp morning coffee. So yes, to pigs all round. Good pigs. If you're ever in the market for a guinea pig, please do check out the rescues. I feel like I'm being tested because the rescues are overflowing and they're like, please take our guinea pigs. We have so many guinea pigs. And I'm resisting. But if you were ever thinking of getting guinea pigs, you totally should. Because you see how much joy they do bring. So yes, They are the best. Oh, Lil says my hair looks nice. Yes, thank goodness. So it's actually a fact that the more relaxed I am, the curlier my hair goes. So this is a good sign. Not that I curled it yesterday. Where shall I begin with the squid news? Thanks. Oh yeah, I dyed it again. I forgot. This is part of me coming back into happiness. You'll be pleased to know. It's usually a good sign if I've dyed my hair. It means I'm back on whatever train I'm on, or there's an event coming up. And there's no events coming up, so that's a good sign. So, firstly, to remain into grim news, I tweeted on Friday a bit of a subtweet, but it wasn't. And I instantly regretted it. So I'll try and explain as little as I can. So I put something like, I've done the biggest, awesomest thing ever, and I can't tell you what it is, but it's awesome, and you should all pat me on the head. Which then obviously led to lots of speculation. And then some other news was released later in the day that was awesome, and they were like, ah, I'm like, no, it's not. I probably shouldn't have said anything, but I did really need those extra head pats because it was awesome. And I'm not telling you what it was, because I don't actually have to tell you everything. Who knew? But I just really wanted to share how cool and how I had this massive boost, because it's something that's been an issue for me for a very long time in my life. It's been an ongoing thing that sucks. Whilst I've been trying to do these million work things that are on at the moment, it's been there. It's been putting me into several meltdowns, several very dark grimness, and it's all over as of yesterday, and will not be a problem. Not yesterday, Friday. And I was so happy because it was finally over. It was the end of that end of the week. I had my day at Mantic yesterday, so I was, for a temporary moment, the happiest I've been in a very long time, which was huge. That like spike of like, yes, it's over, is amazing. And yeah, I'm not gonna say all the details because yeah, I'm allowed my secrets. But it's not a fun, quirky thing. It's been just really horrible, but it's over. And that is definite cause for celebration. And yeah, I just really wanted everyone to be like, ah! So that relief, you know, once something sort of just not up there for you anymore. So that got me in an awesome mood. That started the cool train. And then, hey, where's this there? But to talk about the Mantic day in a bit, I've got my Lucille. Look at that. The Lucille is not related to the news, although it could have been. They won't be bothering me anymore. So the other big news, the actual news that I could tell you about, because I know I have also been teasing several projects that I can't tell you about. One of them was released on Friday, and I only kind of saw as I was going to bed, 8 o'clock at night. It has officially been announced that the official Salute miniature 2024 is made by Bad Squiddo Games. That's us. And it's being made. It's not brand new news to me. I've known since I think the end of last summer when the project began. And I'm also very impressed that I've not told anyone. I've managed to keep this a secret, which is very hard for me to do. And a few times, I think one of the recent shows I went to get, and I went, oh yeah, because I was like, oh yeah, so it's, nothing. So we were approached by Salute back, yeah, I think it was like the end of August or something like that, asking us whether we'd be interested. And I was immediately skeptical, as I am of all things. I'm like, what am I gonna do? And the arrangement's actually pretty cool. So what happened is me and Alan and Salute, well, me and Salute had various meetings, and then me and Alan had various meetings, And then me and the casters had various meetings. And God, this has gone very red with the light, hasn't it? So there were various meetings all happening around that sort of time of how it was going to be done, what it was going to look like. Obviously the cost, because it's, if you see now, it's a big miniature with a big flag. And casting flags onto miniatures, as we know, as you especially know from listening to my show, is that it's very hard to do because they can bend in transit. So I tend not to do that sort of thing. And obviously the big slab of metal adds quite a bit to the cost. So we don't really do it, but they were very insistent on the flag. So we've managed, we had to sort of do the engineering for that because 6,000 of them have been made. 6,000. So that's more than any figure I've ever done at once. 6,000 is enormous. And knowing that 6,000 are cast at once and going to go into this massive pile, they can't bend. I can't have them all with this, like, drooped flag, which would happen a lot of the time. So there had to be quite a lot of thought going into how that's going to work, which is where I came up with the cool Squiddo tentacles. It's like, we'll get some tentacles in there. May have convinced them that it should totally be another Annie, an exclusive Annie figure. So, and I was like, oh, people are going to think I'm so vain, which I'm not. But if you had a chance for a miniature at a big event to be named something, totally call it after yourself. So it's like, welcome to my salute. here is a really cool female figure with tentacles on it, and she's called Annie. Jez says, is that a bit of a cash injection at the beginning of the year then? I cannot comment on that. I'm definitely not going to be rich off it. That sort of side of it was sorted last year. But it's one of the very few times where that sort of exposure. I can't talk too much about it, obviously, the deal of it, but I'm neither rich from it nor poor. So what's going on with this? Oh, what's going on here? I didn't donate them. God, that is going a bit wild, isn't it? I definitely didn't donate them because that would be a lot of money. But I also not mega bucks from it. But it's worth it just to get them in everyone's So the first 6,000 people that'll be at salute will receive one. If I used bad metal. If I use the metal that a lot of other people use, I would be in, because it adds up over 6,000, as you can imagine. But so if I used the metal that some of the other companies use that has a lot more lead in it, I might have actually made some useful money out of it. But as you know, I'm very insistent on them being really good. And that was that obviously they've got this budget and I have these requirements. So I could have lowered the lead level, which I did actually consider. Raised the lead level at one point because I was thinking, oh my lord, this is a huge figure. Could I grab myself a little bit on the side there? But I don't want it to be lead. No one wants lead heavy these days. And there's still quite a lot of companies using a lot of lead. And it's not good for you. And it's just not cool. And so especially with the big flag, more lead would have made it more prone to just doing a big bend. So I took that cut basically to make sure that it was going to happen in that coolness without having to like cut a flag in half and give her a little flag or something like that, or just make it a bit crapper. So I thought, nah, it's worth it. Let's show them that we mean business, because they typically do this with a lot bigger companies. So to be able to be like, this is what you get when you bad Squiddo, it's been really worth it. So I'm really chuffed. I'm really chuffed with Alan. I've written a part in the magazine about the design as well. So some of that stuff. So when that's the one that you get. Do you get it when you go in? I've never been to salute as a punter, so I don't know what the process is. Do you get the magazine, or is it the magazine you buy? So yeah, it's the show guide, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, because I found a recent show guide from a few years ago, I think, when I was tidying the other day. So there's a wonderful article in there written by me as well. So I've been, it's been really cool. So yeah, the first 6,000 people, as Jill says, and thank you very much, the quality is outstanding. Those 6,000 people get to see that firsthand. So it's like, yeah, anyone who's maybe been squid curious, never heard of us, they get it in hand. And I think that's so important. And the only other way of doing that, you have to pay a lot of money if you want to put things into the goodie bag. So it was like, that's an extra bonus. So yeah, they get to see that, and people maybe go, I've heard of that company, but, you know, don't really know much about them. And you're like, damn, this is good. What else do they do? What? They're releasing other pirates on Salute that will fit with these pirates, and then I'll have a whole pirate crew. There's currently only one pirate, but it's because I've been really busy. So there's currently maybe also limited at Salute, but only resin limited at Salute, and then on to metal. I have an amazing second pirate, which is so cool. And she's got a monkey pulling her hair. She's got a monkey sat on her shoulder pulling her hair up, and you will see that soon enough. So that monkey will be available at Salute as well. So it's also pirate theme. They're doing fancy dress, so I'm very much considering going dressed as Pirate Annie whilst trying to also fit in the logistics of money carrying and stuff. But I could have a holster for the card machine. I could do just card and have my holster be like bang. So yes, it's always looking at me. Dez says didn't go for CEOcast. No, I didn't. I don't know why. Because the figure last year was CEOcast, but it's not this year. So what have we got here? Jules is having spent multiple days dressed as pirate over the years. Highly recommend. Yeah, I think it's one of the few fancy dresses I can actually mix in with being show practical as well. So that could be quite cool, being a Pirate Annie. So that's really cool. It's some recognition, which I'm always very happy about, because I do crave the recognition, even though part of me is like, doesn't matter, you've got lots of customers who think you're great. I'm like, but I need the man above to say that I'm an acceptable company. I don't know. It's that like built-in patriarchy thing, isn't it? We're like, but I need the authority to say I'm good. So the fact that Salute approached me and trusted me as well, because it's a big deal, because if I mess up, getting someone at very short notice to design and cast 6,000 figures is quite the achievement. And I know a lot of people see me as a smaller company than we are. To be able to put that faith in somebody that you think might just be out in a shed or whatever is insane. And really, it's kind of insane on their part. So I'm really chuffed with being able to just be like, you have not chose wrongly. So the casters are just getting to the end of the casting. They've got a cast and bag, all 6,000. And if you've seen the post, they've got a really nice sticker on it. And I'm really happy with the mini. I'm really happy how it's came out. And that it's so solid as well that it can, it's like having to be solid and mass productible and able to be piled up, you know, in such vast quantities and not get messed up in the process, because I don't want anyone to get one and go, ooh. It's enormous, because sometimes we can do some pretty wild stuff with the casting, but it means that each one's got me maybe just tweaking it or someone tweaking it before it goes out, because we're not dealing with thousands at once, strangely enough. So it had to be extra sure that it was, they were going to be quite bomb proof. So that's awesome, and I'm really glad that's out now. And I'm going to be sharing that around as well. And if you see any of the posts, just be like, whoa, Bad Squiddo, they're my favorite. So that is huge, and it's been really exciting. I think because I've sort of had a lot of uncertainty about it, because I was like, is it happening? And you know, you're in that communication part, and I kept thinking at some point maybe they'll go, actually we changed our mind, we're gonna go with Warlord or something like that. So it was a bit like, but it's all official, it's all done, it's all transacted. And yeah, they're just waiting for the last few bits to be put together, and then they can put them in their goodie bag. So thank you for all the well wishes. Look at that, 38 people in the chat. What else have I got? So I've got that, the thing is finished, salute pirates, no idea what that thing I've wrote says. Looks like livid, more livid. Exactly, Daniel, you don't have to lie. Say, just to proclaim out there that Bad Squiddo is indeed the favourite. So those things are tick. I've got notes this week as well. Take that. Yes, we need badges. Ask me about our saviour, Bad Squiddo. So when I said at some point last year, I was like, can't say yet, but it's going to be year of the squid. I've got a few projects like that this year that's going to blow you away. And I'm really excited because, you know, when you're working on something and it's just really knackering and you like you can't see the end result of it, so you're not in that reward bit yet. And now I've got one of the rewards. I'm like, yes, a reward. Yes, this is what we want. And then the reward from the other thing, which means my life's actually going to be all right, which is awesome. Woo! So the other thing. Da-da-da-da. Yesterday, I went... Oh, 40 viewers. Look at that. Yesterday, I went to Mantic Games to play The Walking Dead. And Wes, who's in the chat there, was supposed to come, but wasn't able to. But it was, yeah, it was terrible, Wes. You don't want to go. You might as well. Yeah, it was rubbish. Now Wes is gone. It was really good. I had such a good day. It helps that I was in a an awesome mood. I did the thing where... I was telling Andy on the way there, I said, oh no, it's happening again. I'm going to an event where I'm not in a work capacity and I suddenly go all shy and I forget because I'm like, let's do the thing. And then on the way there, I'm like, oh no, I'm shy. Because when I'm working, I'm very much now cultivated, not a persona, because you know me, it's just me, but I'm more confident. And I think it's because I've got a reason, a purpose. So I'm like, I have job is Bad Squiddo. But when I go to events where I'm not Bad Squiddo, I kind of just like, I am Annie, hello. Hello, I am a gamer. Yes. So I was a bit like that at the start because I got there were a lot of people there. So I was a bit overwhelmed because a lot of people were already playing games. And it's like, do you just go up to people and be like, hello? Although I have made, I made some very good friends at Corehammer by basically going, can I play with you, please? He went, yes, yes, of course you can. But that's always hard for gamers, isn't it? To go, can I play with you? So we had a look around. Some guy on the Walking Dead group had PM'd and asked if I could get him some stuff because they'd put some of the boosters out because they obviously weren't able to sell them previously. Yeah, some guy, I don't think he'll watch this, but even if he does, you are some guy, had messaged and asked me to get him a list of stuff. And I was like, I'm not getting some random guy a list of stuff. And then I'm begrudgingly kind. So I went, fine. So I had this like stack of stuff for this guy. Well, Andy's like, what if he doesn't want it anymore? He doesn't pay you. I'm like, well, I've got some extra Walking Dead boosters, I guess. But he has. And I ended up chatting to him. And he seems very nice. So I don't know why I mentioned this. Just to tell you what a nice person I am. That I went and picked up a substantial amount of stuff for this guy. And then went, oh yeah, that's quite a lot of money, isn't it? But he has the things because he wasn't able to go. It wasn't Wes, though. But yeah, just somebody off the group. Because I was just like, I don't even know who you are. Okay. I think I was in such a good mood from everything. I was like, let's do it, let's go. We got all the stuff, thanks to Bruce and Elvis and me buying a few bits. So we've got the whole collection, apart from the Whisperers and the brand new Commonwealth. So we pre-ordered those and we got, what did we buy on the day? They had a couple of the mats left over, so we got a few mats. Because I don't know what happened to our mats. This could be a good group question, actually. the mats have perished. And I don't know why, because it's not happened to any other mat. And I'm sure it's not a Mantic thing, so it's not a slight on their mats, or I wouldn't have bought more. So I don't know if the person I bought them off stored them weird or had anything spilt on them, or I've stored them wrong. But I store the rest all just sort of rolled up. But they, it's like the rubber bit kind of started sticking. It's gone really sticky and stuck to each other, and then some bits have gone hard. So we've got loads of the mat, like the full mat collection, but they're mostly kind of like, oh, I don't want to get that out. So we want to find out if there's a reason why that's happened, so that the ones that we've just bought don't all go wrong as well. Although you can see one behind me. Woo, look at that. It's the indoor one. I wasn't as keen on, but Andy insisted, so I am under his thumb. It's because we haven't done really any indoor scenarios yet, but we will. And then just a nice thingy there. I have a plug for Mantic. They were selling all their paint, well, all the heat and cold. Yeah, maybe they've been in a garage. That could be it. That's a good point. Yeah, they were selling off army paint and game colour paints for £1. Sorry, Wes. So we got a bunch of those as well. Ronnie did a tour. He was doing tours for everyone, and I've been around there a few times, but I'm a sucker for a tour. It's nice to sort of fantasize and be like, oh, one day I'll have my own room for this and my own room for that. Yes, Goblin's Loft, that's a permanent, so if you pop over, they've still got loads left. So it wasn't an event day thing. Jill says, oh, she's a nice person, there's a pirate mini. Yeah, so a lot of people have said, can we get that pirate mini aside from Salute? You cannot. I will not be able to sell it either. It's not mine, it's Salute's. And that's the point, really, isn't it? It's the exclusive show mini to get you to go there, which you should. But the amount of people that have been asking, you should buy my other minis. That aren't exclusive. I'm like, it's always the exclusive thing. I'm like, oh, if I just released her as a cool pirate figure, it'd have been like, oh, okay. It's like, oh, it's limited. And everyone's like, oh, goblin brain. So, I'm just going to punish you all now and just make everything a limited edition. Don't you agree, Andrew Ransom?
Yes.
Everything should be limited editions. Make everyone scramble.
Yes. Do it.
Those £1 paints is an ongoing, it wasn't an on-the-day thing, was it?
I don't think so.
Andy says unknown, but I think they're just doing it as standard to get rid of it. So yeah, if you want to go down to Mantic when they're open, just buy paints for £1. £1! £1! I should be getting paid for this, actually. I might bill Ronnie. So he took us around the building. That's it. Andy's off to get some supplies. Talking of Walking Dead, he's off to forage. So we got to see all the different areas and just some of the processes that Mantic use. I was a bit sad that they're getting rid of their metal, they're phasing all that out. So the metal area is just slowly shrinking away and there's no hand sculpting anymore. But that, again, that's just my personal preference. I totally get. He had a really good point, actually, talking about licensed products and how digital's way better because it's so much easier to make a little tweak than to have to re-sculpt something because obviously the licensees are very specific, which I think was one of the issues with, one of the issues with Prodos, was it the aliens thing, was to do with lots of delays and tweaks from the license. I can't remember who the licensee is. Fox, is it? But yeah, so that's a good solution to that, is to do things digitally. So that makes loads of sense. And not most of what they do, that's a complete lie. A lot of their bigger Kickstarters now do seem to be licensed things, although they've got their Epic thing on at the moment. So yeah, they got to see some sneak peeks of some of that stuff. They got in the cabinet, they got some of that out. Just looking around a massive warehouse. Don't think it was Disney. It wasn't Disney then when it was AVP. But yeah, anyway, they had a massive shrink wrap machine, which is my dream. So I got to see that. What a beast. It's Dave's turn to type. Dave's making a comment. Surprised no one's made a YouTube account called Dave to start putting in there.
With his picture.
Yeah. Leave me alone, I am typing. Yeah, it was, yeah, 20th Century Fox, that's the one. Bye, Andy. So bye to Andy, he's off to forage supplies. Woo, before the rain cometh. But yeah, the Prodos thing was like blooming ages ago now, wasn't it? It was like 12 years or something. So anyway, Sharky does have a good point. Have all your other minis, just want the salute one as well. Well, hopefully, I know this is mad to say, but hopefully there'll be people there that aren't that fussed about the model. I know, out of the 6,000, I don't know if I want that to happen, but it would benefit you because then you could ask around on some of the groups or if there's people you know going. I'll obviously keep my eye out. Partly tempted, oh no, that would be a bit wild, to do like a trade-in, because I do want some of you to get them, like a trade-in on the stand or something. Don't want a pirate, swap it for this or something. I don't know. Maybe like limited to 20. I could have a think about something like that to see if anyone wants a pirate. Because the other thing is, we don't get the minis as traders, so there's people who are working that want one and can't get one. So I'd like to try and like gather some of them so that I can, you know, especially people overseas that really wouldn't be able to go. But I'll have a ponder, but I can't guarantee, obviously. But yeah, if you know anyone going, then yeah. Or you could make a whole line of pirates on Kickstarter. Pandemonium says, just realised how up-sync my vid is with the chat. It might be me, to be fair. I'm reacting slower to things. So I got here. Walking Dead Day. Yeah, it was wicked. Got to have a proper look. Because it's been about 5 years since I've properly been around Mantic. So it was nice to see how they've expanded and moved things around. They've got a cool little maze, well, big maze of a building. It looks like a surgery or something. So there's all little bits. So got to go around there. Got to have a nice chat with Ronnie, who's someone I admire for being also a bit of a mentalist, which I think he wouldn't mind me saying. So that was really nice. And it's always appreciated when bigger companies kind of have time for you instead of just being like, who are you, you loser? You don't even have a large surgery building. You know what I mean? They could be like that. But he's not. He's always just really, really friendly and helpful, and that's really awesome. And encouraging as well. I don't know why I've got... He was really encouraging, rather than, you know, just, yeah, being a dick. Because a lot of people are, but not everyone. So it's always really nice when people are like that, because there's no need to be a dick. So what else have I got? So yeah, anything else? Walking Dead Days. We played some games, played with the Commonwealth. It was only some test prints they'd kind of like knocked out the day before. So I didn't take pictures because I know what it's like when things aren't quite ready and then people post pictures online. They probably did want us to do that, but I was too kind. So we kind of played with the Commonwealth, which was cool. Really excited. Oh yeah, they showed me the Princess test cast as well. Which is really, really cool. Oh, there was a Jason Argonauts, Jason and the Argonauts mini at Salute. I didn't see that one. How long ago was that? So yeah, the mini of, because I love The Walking Dead. It's one of my absolute favourite franchise IP, and the game I really like. And the FAQ. So Ronnie did an FAQ in the Mantic group. So if you're not in the Mantic Walking Dead group on Facebook, so if you're not in that and you're interested. Then you should go along. 2011. I wonder what my first year was. Must have been 2022, I think. 22. 2012, rather. What's I going to say? Commonwealth, Princess, Walking Dead. God, why does my... I know why my brain does this. What have we got? Yep, totally forgot where I was there. Where am I? Who are you? FAQ, thank you. Yes, so Ronnie did an FAQ in the Mantic group. If you're not in there, you can join it and you can still see the live replay. There's a lot of my questions. I like asking questions that I hope will be beneficial, because I FAQs, I get really aware of how there's loads of terrible questions. And when I've been on either side of the FAQ, I've had to sort of like put my face in and not like, why have you asked that? What have we just come? So I like trying to ask some good questions. So there's a lot of my voice in my asking questions. Daniel's off. See you, Daniel. Have a lovely rest of the weekend. And he answered some good questions. And though you can't hear it in the, because it's just on Ronnie's face, in the background, there's a lot of me going and looking at Andy going, that's really cool. So I thought, this is a good, it's a big, what's it? It's a big ad for Mantic. They don't need the ad, but it's not, because it's that whole, well, it is, but it's just me having a lovely day gaming, which you all seem to like listening to. And it's just, as I posted, it's just really nice being a game, getting to be a gamer and not having to be stressed at an event. As much as I love events, they are a lot of work, and I've always got a million things juggling, and I got to just be like, oh cool, zombies, yay. And the big bit that I was shocked, I thought that The Walking Dead was only back for a little burst just to get the last few bits out. But it's not, it's around. He said, and someone was asking me afterwards, like, did you believe him? And I said, I think I've got a very good BS detector for Wargames news where I can almost translate it into like, oh, I see. No, I think there was nothing in that that wasn't like, yeah, fair enough, that sounds absolutely. So they said it's not, they're obviously not going to be their main winner, but it still has to make some money. But as long as people are buying and playing, it's going to be around like for a while, you know, like years, and they're going to do more releases, more games. So they've got Mark Latham back on board, which I was like, yes. So it is properly back, because I did really think that it was just going to be a bit. It's going to be properly back, and I've not slurped the Kool-Aid. Yeah, as Wes said, James, buy all the old expansions straight away. I'm not sure what they're doing. It's worth checking on some of the things. But they're doing a collector's edition for the new stuff. No, for the old stuff. So if you're a new player, you can get the... They're repackaging, so they're not doing that starter set anymore, but they're doing the collector's edition. The new bits are just a bit cheaper because they're on the pre-order, and it's just to gauge ideas for how many to make. Again, from knowing how all these things work, I'm like, yep, said resin, because obviously it's not going to be the same as it was when it first launched, and that was a Kickstarter, and there was loads of them, like, yep. But even with plastic, even if you've got it tooled, you've still got to do a significant order. But they're hoping that from this initial boost, and sort of test to see if anyone wanted it, because you know, I know what it's like when a lot of people say, we really want this, so you do it, and then no one actually did want it. So they obviously were being careful with that. The plastic's hoping to come back, and it's all just, you know, as you said, it's very community driven, as it's a bit of a Ronnie passion project. So it can't lose money, and it's got to make a little bit of money to justify itself. But it doesn't need to be, you know, it's not going to be their main game or anything. They've got a whole release schedule sort of ready for it. So that's really cool, because I love the game and I want more people to play the game with. And they're doing some really cool tournament support packs and stuff. So I want to get to some events. I'd rather play like campaign with it, just fun things, because I like playing quite narrative, because it's The Walking Dead. That was just really good, because I don't play many games, and that's a game I do play and have the figures for. It's strange, and they're painted. Woo! So getting to enjoy a game, chat to some people. I think most people there didn't know who I was, which is actually nice, because I just get to be a gamer. It's just really nice. It's not going to be limited. They obviously just want people to get it, if you a bit like anything, get it if you can, just so they know, but you're not penalized other than the pre-order price. Walking Dead was awesome. I love Walking Dead. I was in a really nice mood. I got back last night and I painted, nearly got there with the spirit host. I'm going to try to finish those today. and I was then motivated just to finish some of the objective markers for Walking Dead, and I might even get my ramshackle church from Renedra out today. So the rest of today I'm going to be pottering about, because I've just been existing and sleeping. I think, as I've mentioned in the last few sort of things, I've been burnt out. Last week was rubbish. A lot of this year so far has been a mixture of rubbish and just a mixture of really cool stuff that's just really tiring. So I'm going to potter today. I'm going to have a tidy, wander around. I'm not going to be doing any pottery. Might do a bit of hobby, see to my piglets, clean out my mice, because I got them a mouse adventure playground, so put that in there properly. And I have a bit more bad Squiddo news before I go, so don't worry. Oh yeah, my garden. I put a new garden bed in. It's so good. And it's all flowering. The garden makes me really happy. So what else have I got? So next week, what is happening next week in the world of squids, now that I've cleared a few decks? Ghouls to Retail, I've written. Jesse checks in the post. That Renedra Trench is great. I bought one from that great company called Bad Squiddo, who are here doing the salute mini this year, I hear. No way! So the next week, I've got the Ramshackle Church, because I thought, I'm trying to do things first that are simple to paint, so I keep my momentum up. I'm like, well, it's just brown, and wash it and put some tufts on it, let's say. It was really nice to play on different boards, because we don't have much terrain in the house, despite my mega collection at the office. I need to bring some back here to actually play with. So next week, Ghouls to Retail. You can get these Ghouls to Retail and get some money. I need to get some money somewhere. It's now 10 days till it's like one thing ends, another begins. We're on the 10-day countdown to having to pay this four-figure number for the remainder of my UK Game Expo stand. That is how expensive it is. So when people go, just have fun, I cannot. There is so much to invest, and so much time between paying the money and then getting the nice money from the show. If you're thinking about ordering, maybe do that. I've snuck all the ghouls onto the website. I haven't made a big deal of it yet. Ghouls. Yeah, snuck the ghouls onto the website, anything from the ghoul Kickstarter. I still need to do an actual update to confirm that it's all finished. But yeah, I need to photograph, make sure I've got the ghouls photographed nicely, and then get all that packaging made, and then I can start hitting retail with ghouls as well and do a bit more of a louder launch, because I've snuck them on the website, so if you want, and people have been buying them already. I like how you just find things. That makes me happy. Before I've announced anything, someone's just been on the website and gone, oh cool. So all them classic adventurers and all that are all on there, so that's going to be a bit of the priority next week. Ghouls to Retail, getting them all ready and packaged. Community mini check-in, I've written. So I need to check in on how Marty's getting on with the artwork, because I think I left him hanging on an answer to something. So I need to see how he's getting on and confirm. I don't think I've given him the brief for Joan of Arc and Audrey Hepburn. So those need to be drawn. Ironically, at DPD we were on Clown Week. I called it Clown Week last week. I think all my DPD guys were on holiday, and they're awesome, and they were all gone on holiday at the same time. I think because it was kids half term or something? So I had all these clowns instead that were just like, we don't know how to parcel. Do we parcel put on the heads? I don't know. So one of them ended up back at the depot that's got my samples for Joan of Arc and Audrey Hepburn. So I'll get those hopefully Monday. So there'll be those to show off. So that'll be another big update. So that's those four then cast, and then ready to be relatively quickly cast. I just need to get them to painters and nail up the design for the pennant with Marty as well. And that'll be really cool. So I can't wait. So they're happening. And I'm going to aim to get the voting on the go next week. I'll put a warning up before it happens to get the voting up for the next bunch, which I think is just two community minis, and then we'll be caught up, and then we can start doing it for the relaunchy thing, which I also want all tied up before Salute. Salute's always a good date to have things tidied up there. What's Andy written? You. What's that? What's that about? Backdrops. The backdrop book. If you missed the Kickstarter. Oh, you need to paint some miniatures today. Oh, God. Okay. I said that. Okay. I'm going to. I'm going to finish the spirit host today. They need a dry brush on the ghost bits, the highlights on the vines, because there's some vines on the gravestones. Finish off the mud, and then maybe tuft. I don't know what tufts I've got here, so I might finish them off, but I might have to get my tufts from the office to finish them. But they will be finished today. Oh my God. So the backdrops, Kickstarter, John's put them up for pre-order if you missed the Kickstarter. Obviously you get that after the Kickstarter. But if you have money burning a hole in your pocket, it will also be available for pre-order, all those books, on my website, hopefully next week. I decided not to try and force getting that done, because it's quite a few bits to put on the website and all the details and weight them up and make sure the postage is right and all that. I decided that definitely wasn't happening last week, so next week it will be. That's me nearly done, or I'll be getting Lucille'd or something. Andy's in Tesco going, you need to be painting Tesco. Littles, you need to be painting some minis. And I will, God. Don't you hate it when people just go, paint minis, that's what you should be doing. I will. I did do quite a lot. I watched a terrible Adam Sandler film last night, which I know, and you know. You go, yes, all Adam Sandler films are terrible. And I don't know why I've decided I'm going to watch the worst Adam Sandler films I can find. But it's enough brain rot to put on in the background, but maintain me actually painting some minis. Oh my God, it was... which one was it? Grown-ups. A bunch of guys realise that their kids are rubbish because they're on computers all the time. So they go to a lake house and then realise they all hate their wives as well, because wives are awful. And then there's obviously loads of jokes at the expense of overweight and old women. And it's just so bad, it's because it's so bad. I like watching in horror. Because, yeah, there's like an Adam Sandler formula, isn't there? He didn't do his voice in this one. The last one I watched was That's My Boy, which was quite disturbing. But he does that horrible voice in that one. I don't know. They're just so shocking that I've been kind of watching out of, like, people made this and then loads of people bought it or went to the cinema. Oh, my Lord. But yeah, it's like, the wife is bad. Oh, one of the characters has really sexy daughters. Oh no, let's slow-mo on them. But yeah, terrible. Sharknado. So I'm not a fan of films that are made bad on purpose. It has to be authentic bad. So a lot of those sort of B-movies. There were Velocipasta I did really like, and that was made tongue-in-cheek, I think, I hope. But yeah, terrible Adam Sandler, so I might find another terrible Adam Sandler to put on later. And paint some things, and that's it. So that's me whirling through loads of news. Things are good. I had a brief moment of happiness. It sounds so emo, but it was beautiful. I realised I very much am around the best it can get. I think, don't have a mix of my medication and just ongoing lots of stuff at the moment. I get to about neutral and that's like, yes. But I actually got into the happy mode and I was like, oh my God. And I think I'm in a bit of positive, but now I have the looming dread, obviously, of like, oh, what's next? What's next? But today I'm going to enjoy just pottering about and getting some things in order. The self-care that is actually useful rather than just playing Stardew Valley. Just getting some bits together, making my space nicer and doing some lovely bits. Gary won't be here next week, so I'll see you in 2 weeks. Gary, will I be here next week? Yeah, I don't think I've got anything on. Yeah, it was. It was like, oh, I'm happy. This is good. So I'll be working towards more of that happiness stuff. Digging for Britain. Excellent. Much better than Adam Sandler. Right. Sorry to confess my Sandlerism. This is very fluffy. So yes, thank you for coming along. Thanks for sharing in the happiness and new news. I've got my planner with me to be doing a bunch of planner stuff to get all next week nicely sorted. And I'm going to have some breakfast. I don't even know what I'm going to have for breakfast. I might have a brunch. So thank you very much. Thanks for coming along. I might even attempt next Sunday to have a go with the thing where I can put the pictures up. That one. So thanks very much. Good to see you all, and goodbye.